In this section, we want to start off by discussing the rate of change of a function and see how that starts to lead us into a definition for what we mean by the derivative. So in our first example, we want to find the rate of change of the function below. So by rate of change, essentially what we mean, especially for a straight line equation or a linear equation, when we talk about the rate of change, essentially we're talking about the slope of that line. So to find the slope of our line, we could start with our initial point, 0, negative 3, and then see how far we go up and how far we go over to get to that next point, 2, 0. So from 0, negative 3, we have to go up 3, and then over 2, which is going to give us a slope of m equals 3 halves. So from previous classes, that should be familiar. We can also formalize that process into a formula for the slope, which is m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So in that case, if we consider 2 and 0 to be x2 and y2, this would give us 0 minus our y1 coordinate, which is negative 3, divided by our x2 coordinate, which is 2, minus our x1 coordinate, which is 0, giving us positive 3 over 2. So two different methods for finding the slope, one graphical, one using a formula. And something to keep in mind is that for linear functions, rate of change or slope is always going to be constant. So this straight line will continue increasing at that same rate, up 3 over 2. We could go up 3 over 2, we would find the next point on the line and continue in that pattern. But obviously that's not true for all functions. So if we consider this function, what we have is a parabola that clearly doesn't have the same rate of change. Because if we considered the left-hand section of this graph, everything to the left of the y-axis, as we read our graph from left to right, clearly our function is decreasing. And then as we get above the y-axis, so into positive x values, as we read this from left to right, our function is increasing. So rate of change isn't constant once we start talking about curves and any other functions that aren't straight lines. So what we want to look at is how we can determine the rate of change for a function like this. So we could start off by considering a point. Let's say this is approximately negative 2, 2. And choose a second point, which we'll say is approximately 5, 15. So one method for finding the rate of change of this function is to choose any two points on our function and connect those with a straight line. And that is a bad straight line. Let me erase that. So we connect these with a straight line passing through those two points, and we refer to this line as the secant line. So we could have started with negative 2, comma 2 and chosen any second point. I just arbitrarily chose 5, 15. So we could find the slope of our secant line using that same formula that we used above. So this would be 15 minus 2 over 5 minus negative 2, or a slope of 13 over 7. So what we're saying is the average rate of change of our function from x equals negative 2 to x equals 5 is 13 sevenths. So that's not necessarily the information we want. What we want to get to is what's the rate of change at a specific point? Because we can see as we're at negative 2, our function is still in this part of the graph where it's decreasing. So over this larger interval, on average our function is increasing, but right at negative 2, we can see our function is actually following this decreasing path. So what we're going to want to do is come up with the slope of this line that sort of glances off our graph at negative 2. And how we're going to do that is by taking the second point, 5, 15 that we started with, and moving that closer and closer to our starting point. So every time we move that a little bit closer, we change the slope of that secant line a little bit. So obviously this graph now has a smaller slope than the line we started off with. So we'll bring that the distance between those two points closer and closer, sorry about that, until we get two points that are sort of infinitely close together, and we get this line that glances off our graph. So let's take a look, and you can click on this link or type in this link to a browser. Take a look at the same tool we're about to look at, but we're going to look at a slightly better visual example than me trying to draw all those different lines. So this is a tool that was created in a software package called Geogebra. Just allows us to do some mathematical visualizations. In this case, what we have is a graph, that same parabola graphed. We have a secant line being drawn through it at two points. And this first one I've tried to get near negative 2, 2. Looks like maybe it's actually a little closer to negative 2, 3, so I was kind of estimating that point incorrectly. But what we can do is by sliding this value for h, we can change the distance between our points p and q. So as I start to make that smaller, we can see that secant line changing. We actually hit a point where we could choose those two values, or choose those two points on our curve, so that the average rate of change would be zero. We can continue past that, and again, what we're doing is getting that distance between these two points, P and Q, to be smaller and smaller. And let's get right above zero so that line is still there. So what we're trying to do is define the slope of this straight line that we form as the distance between these two points gets smaller and smaller and smaller. And that line that we form when we do this, this line in pink or purple, whatever color that is, this line is called the tangent line. So we're starting off with the idea of a secant line, which is, again, choosing any two points, drawing that straight line, and then finding the slope of that line. But now what we want to do is take that idea and continue shrinking the distance between our two points. And as that distance gets smaller and smaller and smaller, we're forming this line that we would call the tangent line.